Hello kids, how are you? I know majority of you will be fasting. So whenever you feel comfortable, you just go through these slides and try to understand the concept and do the homeworks. Okay, I'm not demanding you to do it today itself or tomorrow like that. Nothing like that. After getting the concepts clear, you try to do that. Okay, because it's a very important concept. In the coming years also, you need this. Okay, so the next chapter is unit 10 decimals. Okay, I cannot go fast because these are very important concepts. That's why I'm giving you small slides like this. Okay, so first I'll give you an introduction regarding the decimals. I'm not sure whether you have studied this in your lower classes. Did you study the decimals in grade 3? Okay, anyway, I'll give you an introduction regarding the decimals first. Okay, so you just have a look here. Everyone, please look here. Here I am writing a number. What's the number? 527. You know this number. You know the place values of this number. What is 7? It comes in the units of ones. 2 comes in the tens place. And 5 comes in the hundreds place. You know this. So, when I am putting, all of you know about this, is it? If I am going to put something after this number, this is a whole number. That means 527 is a whole number. Suppose I can say 527 chocolates. That means there will be 527 number of chocolates. Is it? So after this number, if I am going to put something, it means decimal numbers are coming. Okay. So just have a look here. After this number, I am going to put a dot like this. This is called the decimal point. Okay. After that, I can write numbers. Any numbers. Suppose I am going to write 93. Okay. So, now what is this number? I can say 527. That means it is a whole number. And after the decimal, it is decimal numbers. I cannot call it as 93. I cannot call it as 93. Why? Because it is less than 1. If it is more than 1, I will say 528 instead of 527.93. So, this number is less than 1, less than a whole number. So, I will read this number as 527.93. Okay. After decimal, here I put two numbers. I can put n number of numbers, 931, 934, anything I can write. I am just showing you for two numbers now. So, I will call it 527 point. Decimal point is called 0.93. Okay. Now, let us go in detail about this. This 9 is called, what is the digit 9 called? It is called 10th. Look here. This one is called units or ones, then tens, T-E-N-S. But here, when it comes after the decimal, there is no unit place. Unit is only this. We start from 10th. See, T-E-N-T-H-S. And after that, after tens comes what here? Hundreds. D-R-E-D-S. H-U-N-D-R-E-D-S. But when it comes after the decimal, it becomes hundredth. H-U-N-D-R-E-D-T-H-S. Look, T-H-S. So after the decimal, it becomes tenth, hundredth, thousandth, like that. Okay. So depending upon the decimal, decimal places means what? After this decimal digit, how many numbers are there? They are called the decimal places. So, look at this question and tell me how many decimal places are here. After the decimal, we can see two digits, is it? That means there are two decimal places. So, just have a look here. I have a whole number here, one grid. Here, I am dividing that to 10 equal parts. And one part is colored here. So, we already studied in fraction. One part is colored out of the 10. So, what you will call it? When we say it as a fraction, say it is 1 by 10. That is 1 out of 10. Okay. Then what you should do? You should have a look. How many zeros here? That means now no whole numbers. Because I have a full, suppose one full chocolate. Now what I have done? I have divided that into 10 equal parts. I am describing about only one piece. That means 1 by 10. So it is less than a whole number. Is it? That one piece is divided now. And look here. How many zeros in 1 by 10? only 1 0. So I'm going to write the decimal form of this fraction 1/10. That means just have a look here, 1 0. That means when I write the decimal number, after the decimal point, only one digit should be there. Okay. And here, any decimal places, any whole numbers are there? No whole numbers in front of this. Only one part out of 10. That means 0 whole number and 1 out of 10. That how we will write 1 out of 10? Just have a look. It is, we can say it is 0.1. Look, it is what I can say. It is 0.1. Okay. So 0.1 means this one, same one I am writing. That is only 1 is there. 1 0. So after the decimal, only one digit. Now look here. I am coloring 2 portions out of this 10. So what is a fraction? It is 2/10. So what will be the decimal form for 2/10? You know it is 0.2. Why it is 0.2? Because no whole numbers, only the decimal 2/10. Suppose I am coloring 3. So it is 3/10. And what is the decimal? 0.3. Look here. How many cut points are colored here? It is 5, is it? So it is 5/10, that is 0.5. And 0.5 is called 1/2. Why it is 1/2? See, total 10 pieces are there. I colored 5 portions, that is rest 5 are not colored. So half of that is colored. 5/10 is 1/2. Is it clear? That means whatever is the number, I will just write the number first. And then I see how many decimal places, how many zeros, only 1 0. That means after the decimal, only one digit should be there. Here 5/10, again 0.5. Why I am putting everywhere 0? Because no whole numbers in front of this, only I have one thing, that one itself I have again divided to 10 pieces, and I am describing about different portions of that, is it? So when we go in depth about this, it will be more clear for you. Again, coming to the next one, what we can see, I am coloring how many portions now? I am coloring 9 portions. So what will be that? 9/10, and that is equal to 0.9, is it? So look here, only 1 0. So after the decimal also, only one digit, 0.9. Now the same grid, I am going to divide, same grid, I am going to divide 100 pieces. Instead of 10, I am going to divide to 100 pieces. And now look, I have colored how many portions out of 100? This is the same thing which you studied in the fraction. This one, we are converting the fraction to decimal. How many portions I have colored here? Just have a look. This one is 10, then 20, then 8. So it is 28 out of 100, is it? So 28 out of 100, how I can write in decimal form? See, how many zeros? 2 zeros. That means after the decimal, there should be 2 places. So I can same write 28 first, and I put the decimal in front of that. So it becomes, any whole numbers here? No whole numbers, only this grid, 100 times divided grid only we have now. So I will write 0.28. Okay, let's have a look. Look here. 0.28. Is it clear? So 28/100 is, or I will say this as 28/100 means 100. Okay. 28/10 means 28/10. So 28/100, or I will say 28/100 or 28/108, 0.28.